you very much, Lasky Hillock. I have to say I shivered when I saw this lamentable bill in print. There should have been two bills, and it was dishonest for there not to be, in my opinion. This bill does one thing very specifically and very clearly: facilitate the holding of a referendum. No decent person could vote against a bill that merely facilitates the holding of a referendum. This bill purports to extinguish the Senate, and for that reason, no decent, self-respecting senator could ever vote for it. What the bill does, and I'm reading from the explanatory memorandum, provides that Shannon Aaron is to be abolished, and in consequence of its abolition, amends provisions of the Constitution that confer functions on Shannon Aaron that are premised on the existence of that House. There isn't even a mention of the word referendum. This is the extinction of the Senate. This is force majeure. This is a power grab. And I'm honoured that I was the first person to show it. And I demonstrated through all the subterfuge of government in concealing the power grab to be able to impeach the President and impeach the Supreme Court as well. And they will get rid of this House at their peril, in my opinion. And no kind of emollient speech from the other side will convince me otherwise. The bill is badly drafted. It's highly technical. It's confusing. It's deliberately confusing. Because this is a bit of red meat held out by the Taoiseach to get the guard dogs off their prime, to get them to distract their attention so that Irish people can be fooled. This is the Lisbon Treaty all over again. It's the same bloody tactic. And they didn't even read that. It was confusing. It was deliberately, we were told from Europe, deliberately to confuse the people. I've read legislation in the last 26 years. When I read this first, I thought it was inaccurate because of the way in which the Irish provisions and the English provisions were drafted. I got an expert to look at it. No, but it's done so technically that God Almighty couldn't make head or tail of it. And that is completely and utterly deliberate. Now, I said no self-respecting senator could vote for it. How could they? I've clearly said it's not about a referendum, it's about extinguishing the Senate. This is not turkeys voting for Christmas. This is turkeys being invited to slit their own throats, eviscerate themselves, and stuff themselves at the instigation of the Taoiseach. And let me tell you who pros as Democrats and orators over there, there's not even a suggestion of a vegetarian alternative, because Mr. Kenny from the West of Ireland has blood on his fangs, or he thinks so, and he thinks the Irish people are as stupid as the people who elected his government on false promises. And I'd like to say this, there's all this blather about reform of this doll. I want to say to Mr. Endy, I don't believe a word of it. Show us the colour of your money. Show us the colour of your money. Out with it. Let's see a bit of door reform. There isn't a damn bit of door reform, and the Irish people will be bloody stupid. And they let him abolish the Senate because he's pretending that he's going to, down the road somewhere, make a serious attempt. Why would he? When he has mutilated the Oireachtas, when he has carved the Oireachtas up by one third, when he's halved parliamentary representation, when he's grabbed all these powers of committees, why would he? That's not the direction in which he's going at all. And he quotes various countries. He quotes little Denmark and little Finland. Great! They abolished the second chamber, and they did it in tandem with strengthening massively local democracy and changing the regulations within the main parliament so that there were free votes, votes of conscience. So I believe in the bloody Kenny when he gives a free vote on the abortion bill. Let's see that. Let's see a bit of consistency and honesty. I don't know what Endy Kenny's reading is, but it looks to me as if he's been reading the great essay on simulation and dissimulation by Sir Francis Bacon, because there isn't one tissue of truth in his rotten little speech. This is an appalling situation. If we go down the corridor here, we'll see on the wall a portrait of a smug-looking little man. a little politician who get lost among the crowd in here of core bogues that are trying to abolish us. And his name is Mr. Foster. And when in 1800, he, in no doubt tones of lovely silver Augustan Latin, pronounced the death of the Irish Parliament, he then shoved the silver mace up under his gown and legged it down the street. He was a liar and a thief. And whoever proposes this and whoever votes for it is a liar and a thief and a traitor to the Irish people, as far as I'm concerned. And they should put the portrait of Foster up in that chair if they abolish the Senate as a reminder of the shame brought on Shannon. Now, we've heard how useless this house is. How useless was Mary Robinson, who's a friend of mine? How useless was Owen Sheehy Skeffington? And they had the unmitigated cheek to enroll Mary Robinson, who would be furious at the denigration of the Senate. I know her because I've known her better than any other person in this house knows her. I was a friend of Noel Brown for 30 years. He signed my nomination papers, every nomination until he died. And Noel would be livid at the idea that some grimy little squirt from the other side has been sent out to abuse his name. Noel Brown can't speak for himself, but I sure as hell can. And I would say to those little bamboozers, you're not Noel Brown. You never knew Noel Brown, but I knew him intimately. Without Shannon Aaron, we wouldn't have had the first debate on AIDS. We wouldn't have had a Foreign Affairs Committee. We wouldn't have any debate on rendition. And I handed the papers I got and the work I did down to Michael D. Higgins and the others at the Dole, and they took it up. But it was taken up from this house. We wouldn't have had, I don't think, certainly for some years, the Civil Partnership Bill. And my colleagues here, Dale Fergal Quinn, how many bills has he produced even in this session? The Building Bill. This bill is still stuck, these idiots in the lower house, and they complain about us. And Mr. Endy Kenny had the gall to come into this house and say, or set out on the plinth over there, what did the Senate do to stop the disaster of the Celtic Tiger? Well, I say what I did, and it was. I stood in this chamber and I argued against it, and I made a case that was clear, logical, and confirmed to be right, and thanks to Peter Matthews, I actually put the identical accurate figures and showed they were wrong. And I voted against it. I voted against benchmarking. And I put the names of the bondholders and said they should be burnt. And the Cahillector nearly broke his gavel. None of them in the balls in the Senate had in the door had the balls, including Endy Kenny. And where was Mr. Endy Kenny at that stage? Where was Mr. Endy Kenny, who's now so puffed up and brave and challenging the Senate? He was down there in the lower house, meekly supporting fuel being poured on the Celtic Tiger and its flames, getting involved in his usual corrupt auction politics, and then leading his meek little supporters in to vote in favour of the bank guarantee. And that man has the impertinence to attack the Senate. And they say it wasn't reformed. No, it wasn't reformed. Yeah, and Senator O'Donnell's right. The establishment did nothing about it. Nothing for 10 years, 10 reports, 70 years, and they even got a previous referendum too, and did sweet bugger all about it, which we were all in the university seats demanding reform. What can we do? We can't take over government and force them to do it. They wouldn't do it. Every single government, every single party corrupted this house, but still this brave little ship with its tattered sails and holed and not properly caulked and deliberately leaked by those blackguards in their own corrupt interests. It sails through the storms and it's held firm in its own way for the Irish people. And I honour it. I honour it far there. We had other countries from all over the globe brought in that had abolished themselves. No wonder he didn't mention Mr. Mugabe. The first thing Mr. Mugabe did was to abolish the Senate. So maybe Mr. Kenny sees himself in the mould not just of a little Napoleon,
1 minute, Senator,
but also in the guys. I just looked today, this very day, a bill by Senator Zappone and ours was accepted here. Another bill accepted here. Now, the leader talks, he starts off with Mr. Kenny about his Dáil reform. Rubbish. Don't believe a word of it. 14 Dáil committees will be established. Of course they will. Of course. Lots of jobs for the boys. Jobs for the boys. Jobs for the boys. Jobs for the boys. And this is what the Irish people will vote for. Jobs for the bloody boys. The ones who dragged us into the ruins of this economy. That's right. They wouldn't bring a bill on such flimsy grounds or off the top of his head. That's exactly what he did. I was here, I saw it. Nobody knew it. The face on Francis Fitzgerald. Ask Francis Fitzgerald, did this wonderful open heart teacher ever let her know what was going on?
The chair is loath to intervene, Senator.
Beg pardon?
The chair is loath to intervene, but I must remind
then
you
don't.
That your time is up.
It's just the unspeakable dishonesty of this speech. He's going to look at the presidency and he's going to reduce the number of members to 14 in that house. Impossible for an independent to get, but will he listen to the voice of the people? This wonderful Democrat, this absolute Democrat who wouldn't recognise democracy if it came up and puked in his face. He's saying, oh, the presidency. Well, now let me tell you, despite all the manoeuvrings, I got a thing through the convention which he wouldn't even let Shannon Aaron be discussed in. I got a thing through about the presidency to allow the people of Ireland a greater say. That's a bit of democracy. 97% of the people at the convention voted for it. Let's hear a titter out of Endy Kenny about that. I understand I'm nearly at my limit, so I will just end by saying, I reiterate my challenge to Endy Kenny to come into this house or to better, I think what our challenge was for television or radio, I'll debate with him and I will peel the layers of dishonesty and populism away from him and show the Irish people what's really being done to them so they won't be fooled another time until they know what way to vote. They'll vote against this bill, which is a fraud perpetrated on the Irish people, as gross as a fraud that was perpetrated by Woods Halfpence in the 18th century, and was defeated by the oratory and writing of the great Jonathan Swift. And that's where power lies sometimes, in the hands of the weak, in the hands of the people who are being battered, who are having democracy torn from them. And we can, if we let the people know what's happening,
thank you,
we
Senator.
Can stymie this miserable little act of political vandalism.
Thank you, Senator.